Hello guys, sorry for the delay. Oh, like literally, I am sweating. I'm just coming on. I went for a program and I just got back in, so I've not been able to like set up properly, but I just had to like show up, and I haven't even sent our guest for today message that like he should be here. Today we are meant to be looking at the benefits or the opportunities in real estate. Let me quickly send a message to the person that is meant to take today's segment, and apologize to him that it was my laptop that messed up and everything just froze. How have you guys been? I went for an O1 bed today and just got back. It's not easy, but then I just had to like show up. Like I needed to be here for you guys. All right. So if this is your first time of being a part of the show, please, you know how we do it. Your name, your location, put it in the comment section and let me welcome you especially. All right. I'm kind of tired right now and I'm trying my best to, what's the word now? To get myself together. Like I'm actually sweating like a Christmas goat. Anyway, hope you guys are well. How is life over there? How is everything in general? What's happening? What's happening? So I'm waiting for our guests to come on. He's someone that like has been
Here
here
before.
before. And okay. Yay, so we have required for young. Thank you for being a part. Oh dear, can you imagine? So I can see parts of me. Okay, let me remove one of it. Remove, sorry. I was trying to like be sure that everything was there. I didn't know that like I was trying to like okay, I was trying to do it in such a way that like if my phone doesn't work out. At least sorry, my laptop doesn't work out. My phone would at least work out. Mr. John, are you ready to be a part of the show? I can see you setting up. I am so sorry, guys. I'm sorry for the whole delay and everything else. I hope you guys can actually hear me properly. And all. Mr. John, are you ready for us today? Hello, Mr. John. I need to know if you are set. We're looking at the opportunities in what's the word now? Opportunities in real estate, and Savior John Uwa would be here to shed more light. He's been here on the show before. The first time he came here was when Mrs. Rukayat Oladipupo was also here. They both were here on the show, and today he'll be talking more on real estate. All right, my network is kind of bad and but kind of slow, really. I don't know. I didn't do a refresh before I kick started, so please pardon or bear with me till we're able to set up. Mr. John, are you set? I need to know if you're ready so that we would kick off. Are you ready, sir? Are you ready for us? Let me check on him. If you guys can still hear me, please let me know. Just nod your head for me and like let me know that like you guys are here. Mr. John, your network is kind of poor at the moment. Are you ready now? Can I bring you on? Okay, just a minute. All right, no problem. Okay, so before we kickstart, what can we talk about? I went to Ondo Town. Yeah, let me just gist before we start off fully. I went to Ondo Town. It's about an hour from here, but getting transportation and all, it took about 2 hours for me to get home back from the venue. And I went to eat pounded yam. Like, it's something I don't get to eat regularly. But this time around, I went to eat pounded yam. Like, I had my fill. And happy married life. Delaney went for his wedding. It was interesting. It was a small wedding, small gathering, and all went well. When I mean all went well, I mean that, like, the food got to me. Have you ever been to a wedding that, like, they'll be sharing wedding, sorry, sharing food, and then, like, it has gotten to everybody, and then, like, two tables, rather, before it gets to you, food finishes, and then, like, when they are sharing drink from one end also, and then, like, two tables also before it gets to you, like, it finishes. I always try my best to be prepared for whatever it is that will come during wedding, so I try to eat before going. But this time around, my guy Adewale made sure that, like, I had my fill, and I am happy. I'm tired, but I am happy. So we are still waiting for Mr. John to be ready for us, so that, like, we can kickstart. Mr. John, are you ready, sir? Are you ready for us? I think I'm going to bring him on the show just to be sure. Hello, Mr. John. Hello, Mr. John, you're on the show right now.
Okay.
We can't get to see you. I think there's something wrong with your network. But we can hear your voice. We can hear your voice, but we cannot see you. Okay, or we can see you, but then your video is frozen.
Okay, but can you hear me clearly, please?
Yes, I can hear you clearly.
Okay, if you can, I think maybe still better, at least.
Okay, so let's kickstart. Yes.
I've been switching from one Wi-Fi to another.
I understand how it feels like, the Nigerian factor bar.
Also, I can hear me.
Yes, I can hear you. I can hear you.
Yeah, I'm trying to switch from one Wi-Fi to another, you know, just to have a... okay. Can I start, if you can hear me?
Yes, we can hear you, but we still cannot see you, but you can kick off. Because we do not have all the time.
Maybe there's not some, I don't know, is there something I'm not doing right? Yeah.
Would you like to log out and log back in? Like, just go off and then come back on?
Okay.
All right, then. Let me remove you briefly. All right, thank you very much. Whew, I thought I was going to take my bath before coming on the show. I got here 6 p.m. and my laptop froze and all that. We're still waiting for Mr. John to come back so that we would kick off. For those of you that are watching, how are you guys? Like, how's the weekend going? Hope you guys are enjoying. I'm sure you guys can see that, like, on a very good day, you guys don't get to see this part of the thing. Like, the way I always set my screen, I don't know why it tilted, but I couldn't set it properly. All right, I think Mr. John, are you ready? Just nod your head if you're ready for us right now. I can see you. All right, great. So let me bring you up on the show. Okay. So you'll be the one talking about opportunities in real estate. I would go off the screen. So if there's any hitch or anything at all, I'll let you know. Okay? Can you hear me, sir? Just start. Okay. Can you hear me? Mr. John. All right. I think I had a little hitch at a point. My network is back now. All right. So over to you. I'm removing myself from the screen. Let us have what you have for us today. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Sorry. I, for just logging in, I had to, like, I went for a patrol, my FRSC patrol today, so I couldn't meet up going back home, so I had to just stop by somewhere to do this. Yeah, good evening, everyone, and happy weekend to you. So we're going to be talking about real estate opportunities in real estate today, and it's just an opportunity for some of us that are finding it difficult to invest or to understand what real estate is. You know, so we'll be looking at one or two things because of our time. I know our time is fast spent already. So this time, this broadcast today, we're going to look at what real estate is, the the categories of real estate that is where the opportunities will. Yeah, so of course we are familiar with the word real estate, with that people saying real estate left, right, center. But real estate is simply is a class of real property. You know, when you say real estate, they are putting it in a class of real property that includes land and anything permanent. Anything permanent, when you talk about real estate, you talk about land. When you talk about real estate, you talk about something permanent, you know. And when you say something permanent, something that is attached, there's something that is attached, it might be a man-made or it might be a natural thing. Like when it comes to land, land is a natural thing. Buildings on the land is a man-made thing, you know. So we need to understand what real estate is before we can see that opportunity in it. I don't know, can you hear me please? Or am I just talking to myself?
I can hear you. I can hear you. Don't worry. Continue, sir.
Okay. All right, sir. Thank you. All right. So want to quickly. I want to talk on the categories of real estate, and I have five categories here. The first one is residential, and we have commercial, residential, commercial, industrial, raw land, special use, residential, commercial, industrial, raw land, special use real estate. We're going to look at that later, but let me just quickly glance through one or two things before we go back to that aspect, you know, because this is what will give us that, will make us understand those opportunities in terms of real estate. Yeah, okay. There's something we need to understand when it comes to real estate. There's something we need to understand that is a key thing that we have to understand in terms of real estate before you invest or before you feel. Before you see that opportunity in real estate, one of the things you need to understand is the land. Land. You know, last time I was here, I made mention of some properties and then talked about land aspect. I discussed about real estate. You know, so in terms of land. You know, we all know that land refers to the earth surface, both the center, both the down to the center of the earth. It's all about land. You know. And when you talk about land, for example, we talk about trees, talk about minerals and other features like water and meat. So we have to understand that land is real estate. Land is real estate. And also number two is real estate. The real estate we're talking about, you're talking about real estate. It is the land. Like I said, yeah, real estate is the land. Because anything permanent, both man-made, additional such as house and buildings, you know, real estate is the land and anything permanent. That is the building on it. The building on that land is real estate. The building that you have, the property, before you can say you have a property, must have a land, a piece of land, and there must be a building. You know, that is if you want to move further. Some people out there, they have land, but they don't have any building on it. That is man-made. You only have a natural, the natural feature, that is, land is all about real estate. I'm emphasizing more on land because when you talk about real estate, if you even though you decide to buy a property, the property will still be on a piece of land, you know, and that land is what you have. That is what you have at that moment. That's what they want. If you want to get a document to be on that property, maybe sometimes back, if I'm opportune again, if I'm about to come back, I will talk on documentation. I don't want to divert now. You know, so the third one is real property. You know, I want us to understand that real property is different from personal property. Real property is one of those two main classifications of property, like the ownership. When you say the ownership of something, that I'm the owner of this particular thing, like the benefit. Sorry, please. Yeah, the rights you have on the rights you have on a particular property. It is what we call real property.
Alyssa, your audio has been muted. I think you pressed something. Now you are off.
I'm sorry, I'm trying to disengage it because someone is calling in. That's...
Oh, wow. Okay.
Asuba, you need to do a research on this. So whenever we are on podcast, nobody, no call should come in.
I think what you can do is you connect to a wireless network and then put your phone on airplane mode. That will be the best option for you.
Okay, let me do that right now, please.
You would probably go off if you should do that right now as you're live.
Okay. Let me quickly, because our time is fasting already. Let me just
do. All right, that. So okay, please continue. Thank you. Call back.
Okay, yeah. Okay. I was talking about real property and personal property. Personal property here, if we talk about vehicles, talk about your smartphone, your furniture, your clothes, is the personal property. So personal property is different from real property. Real property is your owner, like the ownership of a particular thing, the ownership of that land, ownership of that building. But you cannot be the owner of that particular piece of land. You don't have the documentation on it. If they have the right documentation on your name. You know, I was with a client in my real estate. He said he has a property in Ogun State close to him, and he does not have any proper document on even the land, the family musical receipts. I said, no, that land does not belong. You might have paid a huge sum of money, but the land property does not belong to you because you don't have the right document. So real property here, it's what will make you be the benefit, the right of to be the owner, that you can claim the ownership of the particular property here. So we have real estate. In total, everything, generally, everything, when I say real estate simply involves the physical surface of the land. Physical, so that's all the stories I've been saying ever since. It involves the physical surface of the land, which lies above or below it. The physical surface of the land is what we call real estate. That's permanently attached to it, attached to that particular land. So going back to that category of real estate that I made mention of, I said residential real estate. Residential real estate, this is one of those opportunities that we have to see. You need to understand, you need to know in terms of real estate before you invest or put that your big money, that your life savings into it. Residential real estate is like a residential purpose. When you have a particular property for a residential purpose, for example, when you have a condo, you have a family home, you have like a single family, like a duplex, like a townhouse, is what we call residential real estate. That means you are investing in this property to maybe to buy, you bought this land for you to build and then an apartment and rent it out. That is one of the opportunities in real estate. You can buy either apartment, or you can buy a land, you build it and then rent it out, build it to apartment and your unit of blocks, and you rent it out. That is what we call residential, and it's called rental income in real estate. That is called rental income. Then number two, we have commercial real estate. Commercial real estate is used exclusively for business, you know, for business purposes. Like when you have complex, you have gas station, you have hospital, you have grocery store. You know, I have a client that one of my clients I do survey for. You know, the man does is he has properties into real estate. He has properties all over Lagos, I'm sure even in Adams, Otumba's city, Akure. I think it's from Akure. He has series of properties. And what he does is strictly commercial. And this man said something to me, when I asked him, he said, I believe I prefer doing commercial than residential, because if I do commercial, anybody that will come in there, they are using it for their office space or for a business space. And nobody wants to delay the rent, because they know that if they delay the rent, if you kick them out of that place, they will lose their office address. And if their client is coming, the client will not meet them there. So it's actually someone that is his own reasons why the reason why he invested is investing in commercial, not residential. So those are one. This is also one of the opportunities we need to know in terms of before you venture into real estate. Then we have industrial real estate. Industrial real estate is like any property used for manufacturing, for production, for distribution, you know, research and development. You know, when you have and for that, thank God now in Lagos we have some of these things, some of these estates in Lagos, yeah, especially in Bejileki, you have an estate that is strictly commercial, no residential. If you are going there, if you want to do anything commercial, you can. That's the only property, that's the only land itself for clients. And they have, we also have some properties that is strictly farmland. You know, in Epe, you have strictly farmland, no residential, no commercial, strictly farmland. You know, so all those things is an avenue. You know, some people feel, okay, I want to go into farming, but they are yet to see a suitable place. You know, in Lagos State, a part of it is designed for farming, for agriculture, and part of Kurudu also is designed for agriculture. So if you want to venture into that aspect of agriculture, then those are the good preferred place for you. Then number four, I said land. Land includes development property, you know, vacant land and agricultural land. Like I said, land is part of the category, part of the opportunities in real estate. It might be a vacant land when you have, I want to buy this land, maybe later in the future sell it. But mind you, you need to do a proper documentation before you just abandon that land. Because all these land grabbers, they don't joke anymore. You know, they just grab your land if care is not taken. So make sure you have a proper documentation on it. If you are ready to do anything on it. Then number five, I say special purpose. You might invest in real estate. You might venture into real estate for special purpose, and it might be for use for public use. For example, like maybe you want to build a library, you want to use it as a park, like a place of worship, like a school, government buildings. You know, that's the special purpose. That's one of the categories also in real estate, special purpose. Like on the island, around Marina, you know, there are some piece of land that are there. Maybe the owner, like they don't have anything, they don't have money to build at the moment. But what they do is that they just use it for strictly, they use it for car park. And like what I go to work Monday to Saturday, like my office is around Marina, and I pay for car park, I pay 700 every day. Every day, 700 in 6 days, and 700 multiply that 1 month. You know, I'm not the only one. Other people are paying 500 for a car, 700 for a Jeep, and you know, this is another area of another opportunity in real estate. They don't have anything. They don't lease it out and have money to build, but they just use that land, that piece of land, for car park. You know, that is another opportunity you can see in real estate. And when you talk about important factors for real estate investment, is you have to look at the location. The location really matters in terms of real estate. Location really matters in terms of real estate. I've seen a lot of clients that when I go to do survey for them, and when they give me the location, I drive as if I'm going to my state. You know, I wanna be like, come, this is a good state, but I've been on the wheel as if I'm going to my state. You know. Because some of them don't have that mindset. You see, because my colleague said they bought a piece of land at Kurudu for particular price, that means Kurudu might not be your kind of what's it called, your vision or your what you want to invest in. But because you have people, you have a friend that wants to invest, that's when you start seeing a big mansion in some of those axes, and then after a while you hear that the person wants to sell it. Not that the person is having problem or have issue, but because you just feel no, I can't, this place is not developed. So you have to make sure you have the location, you have to make sure you have the view, understand the location before you invest in real estate. If the place that can get ROI, return on investment, at a good return on investment maybe in a year, you know that this is what I bought and this is what is selling now. And some of those places, because if you look at the island, you know, some of those places are child places that you know that development will occur in no time. So you have to use that. That's what some of those important factors you have to look into before you invest. You know, investment purpose is is like we also have investment purpose. So lack of the purpose may lead to unexpected results. We have investment purpose, and this can lead to unexpected results. When you invest, you don't have the planning, proper plan in terms of investment. It leads to unexpected. I have a piece of land, you know, somewhere in Ogun State that I hardly go there, because when I bought it then, I don't have that vision of real estate. I just believe I'm a surveyor. I can just buy it. But over time, I hardly go to that place, you know. So those are the things also that we have to look into when it comes to real estate. And you have to also be careful with leverage. You have to be careful. You know, what I mean by that, I'm saying, you know, in this, some of these proper real estate developers right now, they have payment plan. And if you can find and do this payment plan, can do that, be sure, and you have to understand how to undo that payment plan. If you are picking up collecting loan to invest in real estate, be sure that you know how to undo it, you know, because some of these things can weigh, it has actually weighed a lot of people that I know down. See, that is why you see developers right now, what they do is that instead of them going to the bank to loan money, they tell someone to tell people to come in, bring their money, and get a particular unit or a particular apartment out of what they are building. And it happens a lot around Unilag, around Akoka. You know, you build a room cell for students, and instead of them going to the bank, they tell you to bring your money, you're bringing something like 1.5 million, you put it into it, then you own that unit, that room cell for a room and parlor. You own it for maybe like for a period of 10 or 15 years. So you be the landlord of that particular apartment for 10 or 15 years. You know, so those are is actually another way in investing in real estate. Another way of investing in real estate, you have to be careful with the leverage so you don't run into debt. You know, and one other thing I would like to say here is not about investing alone. You know, sometimes we have some developers, some companies that they do land banking. You know, when we say land banking, is an avenue whereby I have the money in the bank, but the money is not yielding. Instead of that, you see people coming in to collect. You see bank with deducting from 100 naira, 150 for stamp duty and all that. So what some of them, I tell my clients that, why don't you do land banking if you know you don't have anything to do with this money? Invest if it's 3 months. Every 6 months or a 1 year payment plan where you have ROI, like if there's a particular percentage on your investment, maybe in a year, if it depends on what you want, the plan you want to do. And this also comes with a good day, imagine it's secure because you have your insurance, you have your protected check, and you know, all the reliable companies. So it's another avenue, it's also a way to invest, it's also an opportunity in terms of investing in real estate. So you might not want to buy a land at that moment, but you just have this fund that is just staying in the bank, and they've been deducting your money. So you just want to invest. That banking is also another aspect of another opportunity in terms of real estate. And there's something else I would like to say, like quickly, so I can round up. Yeah, I have from being a surveyor. I have a company, a group of companies, a realtor group that we could also bring in realtor for free. It's just a partner, then bring in realtor with our developers that we partner with, so the market properties, and which Otumba knows about it because he sees my post all the time. Yeah, so we what we do is that instead of you, and some people might feel, okay, I want to do this, but why can't you, or maybe I have a job, my job is not really, or I have a nine to five job. Is another avenue to understand what real estate, to key into real estate. I've been selling, or like, let me say, marketing properties, bringing your client to market, get a commission. You know, when you get a good commission, and by so doing, some, I know some realtors will say, I don't need a commission, just keep it for me. Keep it, they will tell us that we should keep the commission living with the developer, that they want to invest, they want to buy so particular property, they want to buy a piece of land for this amount. So keep my commission, I'm not collecting it. As soon as you get to do something, that's a payment, that's an initial deposit, and they do that a lot. So it's another way for you while you're marketing and you're getting bringing clients, you're getting a commission, can also as well key into that property, the property of your choice. You know, and I know one or two, I do not one or two, like so many realtors that they have more than three, four, five land, and they have some of them are even doing apartments because they just did, okay, fine, this commission, I don't want to take it, let me use it to invest. You know, so this is another way which if anyone that is interested can as well talk to Otumba. I mean, you can reach me through Otumba with that. So in conclusion, because I don't take much of your time today, in conclusion, let me just read this out. Real estate can help diversify your portfolio. When stocks are down, real estate is often up. When stocks are down, real estate is often up. When things are not moving. Okay, for example, let me say this. During COVID-19, everybody's complaining, everyone is indoor. But some people actually see the reason why. Some people don't know the reason why they should own a house, they should own an apartment, they should own a property. But when they stayed at home, they were at home for like a month, 2 months. So they now say, oh, maybe I have my own, the property to myself, to my name. I will have that comfort, you know, because most of us, especially in Lagos, we move in, we leave home by 6 o'clock, come back later around 9:10. So we just stay for a few hours and leave the house again. But because we stayed at home for a longer period, some people feel, oh, I need to own this and I'm waiting for my own property, you know. And during that period, I believe me, like me, someone or two are complaining, but me, I didn't make sales. Sales was as in like people called from UK, from US, you know, Nigeria. I was right on my bed. I was making, you know, people are investing, sending forms to them. You know, they fill the form, make payments to the company's account. And a lot of people invested during those periods. So when there's challenges, when stocks are down, real estate tends to have a good return on investment. Remember, I said location matters. When you invest in the right location, you have a good return on investment. Real estate investment can also provide steady cash flow. Can also provide steady cash. Another opportunity in real estate can also provide steady cash flow. Like the rental income I talked about, it can provide steady cash flow for you. You know, this is a part. You know, a lot of people, they say, I'm retired. They have a lot of properties. So what they do is that they just sit down and eat from that property. They sit down and eat and enjoy from that property. So in conclusion, in terms of investment, real estate, the best time for you to invest in real estate was yesterday. The best time for you to invest in real estate was yesterday. But because you chose not to invest, or you don't have the opportunity, or you don't have that, there's nobody to educate you on that. Okay, let's assume if you don't have anybody to educate you on that, to invest in real estate yesterday. But another best time for you to invest in real estate is now. Another best time for you to invest in real estate is now. So I will advise that you look into it and then look into the opportunities that are in real estate. Thank you, and thank you for listening.
Wow. Like, I just have to say, wow. Today's session, I have learned a lot, Mr. John Uwa, and believe you me, I just need to say a very big thank you. Thank you for giving us this knowledge that a lot of people might not even have any idea about. Thank you very much for impacting us, especially myself, for impacting me, because I learned one or two things that like I never thought were possible when it comes to real estate. Thank you. Thank you very much, Mr. John Uwa. And for every one of you guys that are watching live, or those of you that would watch the replay, if you need to get in touch with Mr. John Uwa, is this your Facebook name? Let's start from that. Mr. John.
Okay, my Facebook name. My Facebook is long. So Jean John Largeman.
Are you on Instagram or
Yes. On Instagram you can find me Jean John Reuters. Jean John _ Reuters.
Great. Dan, J-N-J-O-N, right?
Yes, _ Reuters.
Okay, sorry, hold on. Let me try to like underscore Rialto. Hold on. I'm gonna put that on the screen right now so that like so that anybody that needs your service will be able to reach out to you. Is this, did I get it right?
Janjan,
Okay, so for those of you that would like to get in touch with Mr. John Uwa, sorry, Surveyor John Uwa, pardon me, sir. Your Lordship, sir, pardon me, sir. For those of you that would like to get in touch with Surveyor John Uwa, his Instagram handle is janjan underscore realtor. All right. Send him a message, tell him that like you saw him on the Otumba Adams show, and I am sure that like he'll be more than ready to put you through. His services are not free, please. They're no freebie, even in Freetown. There's nothing free in Freetown. His services are not free, but I can assure you that you are safe in his hands because I have known him since my secondary school days. We went to the same secondary school, Lagos City College, and I can beat my chest. If Baba dupe any one of them, I mean, I can't hold me. I mean, I hold my hand like this. I am saying it to the world because I have known him over time, and he has been consistent. He has been trustworthy. He has integrity. So please, if you'd like to use the service, reach out to him, and you can also carry me along if you feel that like, okay, you do not know him, but you know me. So carry me along as you are making your dealings with him, and I am sure that like whatever question you have, whatever business you would like to do with him, it would go smoothly. I can assure you of that. Once again, Mr. John, thank you for being a part of the show. Like, thank you because I thought today's show was going to be a flop, but with what you delivered today, sincerely speaking, you deserve an award, sir. You deserve an award. Thank you very much. I really do appreciate you. From the bottom of my heart, I appreciate you very, very much. For real, man. Like, I appreciate you.
Thank you so
All right,
much.
for you guys watching us from home, I hope you've been able to learn one or two things about the opportunities in real estate. If you've never thought about going into real estate, this is an opportunity for you. As Mr. John said, that like the best time to go into real estate was yesterday. The next best time is today. So it is better for you to start making plans for your future. You would not be young forever. Even if you're still hustling right now, you feel that like you don't have enough resources, right, to use to go into real estate, start small. I think you made mention of something about leverage. Maybe like you own units of apartments, and then like they will lease it to you for a number of years, and over time, like you make your money back, you make profits with this. You don't have to start big. You don't need to have like the 10 million naira, the 50 million naira. And that is why I said that, like, if you have any question, further questions, please reach out to Mr. John Uwa on his Instagram handle at janjon underscore realtor. Okay. Thank you guys for being a part of this show. It seems as if one team is playing football today, Abi.
Yes,
And
that
Mr.
is
John.
painful. My team is playing football. But
Okay, I'm gonna
I have to be on Otumba Adams show.
I am grateful, sir. I am gonna release you right now, yeah, so that you can go and watch your program. I
I'm
say
still
your
with you. We are going to end this together. I'm here.
Okay, no
I'm
problem.
ready
I
with
hardly
you.
watch
Here.
football though. I'm not a football person. Or maybe I used to be, but then like I give up on this. I don't know. Anyway, thank you for being a part of the show.
Book person
Hopefully you
now.
guys watch
Book.
us from home. Thank you for being a part of the show. We appreciate you guys for taking our time to watch us. I said earlier that like I was rushing down from Anowanberg. Mr. John could not leave his office because he had to be here. If we can take our time to try to impact you guys, the only thing we require from you guys is please share the word. Tell people out there that there's something called the Otumba Adams Show so that we can grow this channel on YouTube and on Facebook. We can have more viewership such that we'll be able to like help more people live better lives. All right. Thank you very much. And on this note, Mr. John, do you have any last words before you go?
Can you hear me, please? The last word I have is still what I is actually what I said earlier. We like you've said it all, like we are not growing younger. So So our advice is, my advice here is that anything you want to do, make sure you do the right thing right. The right thing that you always want to do, that right thing you feel you're doing, make sure you do it right. And how can you do it right is to go through the right process and invest rightly.
True. Thank you so very much. We are grateful. Thank you, sir. All right. From me, invest in real estate. It is the next oil. I watched a video recently on YouTube about Zanzibar, and I saw the real estate development happening in Zanzibar, and I was wowed. And the same thing also is happening in Nigeria at the moment. Real estate is the next big thing. Please put your money into it, and you would not regret making that decision. All right. Thank you very much for being a part of this show. It is time to say goodbye. Have a lovely weekend and be the best version of yourself as God created you. Take care, and signing out.